Okay, so I guess I changed my mind. We gonna get into some information today. Like I said now, Judea Black, Shalom L'Chaim, purified drink of water. They got it, is out there. Shouts out to the 12 tribes. Support the people, not the cause, man. If you go stand for Israel, stand for Palestine. If you're gonna stand for Palestine, just stand for Israel. Like I said, claim land, but not in our name. Not my name, not this time, you know. We're gonna get into some information. So the information I'm giving you is not like I'm giving you information in order that needs to be taken in that context. It's not like, you know, I started from day one and worked my way down. You know, I talk about Latinos, I talk about African Americans, I talked about Russian, Europeans, we've talked about Chinese, we've you know, Asiatic, we've talked about Inca Indians, we went left field and talked about Anunnaki, we went right field and talked about segregation with black people, Jim Crow, and we just been, you know, Kush, Ethiopia, talked about a lot of Jewish stuff, talked about a lot of Hebrew stuff, talked about some biblical stuff here and there, and I showed you all my waters, you know, we got it is up there, I got it is right here, we've been talking about waters, man, where them waters from, what them things do, where these waters from, and what these things do, right here, you know, shit, we was talking about pass along, I got your pass along. You playing pass along, taking one and send out, give it to somebody after you read all the information and tie it back up and pass it on to the next, and they get the information and take their in send out and, you know, pass it along like that if you believe or you shall achieve or whatever you feel like. And and we done a lot. A whole lot from here. Now my main thing is that this information is not like that. It's not stacked up like that. Now, I may be stacked up like that, but the information ain't. It's all over the place, and that's just how it's going to be. I told you I was trying to get to a point, so I got to get all this information out. Hopefully, we get to that point before I'm all over it. They shut this thing down, and this is over with, or whatever. Yeah, anyway, so we about to do some more information. Now, I said I was going to get into the Kemet and all of that, and I was like, I'm going to contact... Dr. Silk, see all that. I haven't got that far. I reached out a bunch of times and I got nothing back. So I don't know what to do about that. I'm just going to have to proceed with that information on my own, which I do have my own researchers and our own little team working on, but I would have loved to get information from that. So maybe one of these days my call will get answered and we'll go from there if I can get in touch with them. But I've been calling Dr. Silk. I have been calling. So anyway, I've called too many times, to be honest. Anyway, let's get into some next information, and this is about to be the origins of the Egyptian civilization. Then we'll go to some other videos. Like I said, I wasn't going to do none of that today, but we doing that today. Let's do it. The setup, I was like, y'all never see the setup again, is because I was answering emails, because I had 12 chime-ins today, man. That's cool, you know, so I got apparently nobody receiving the waters. Somebody got a stack of water somewhere that they holding on to. So, I hope anybody's selling them out there. I give you one, you just pay shipping, okay? That's it. But you got to have received pass along. And you going to email me after you get pass along. And then I'm going to know if you read pass along. Or you indulge in the pass along, then you'll get your water. After proof and validation of your heritage. And here you go. Here you go right there, though. But anyway, that's the... email me if you can get one of those to pass along. And I shoot you one, and you gotta pay shipping. So that's what it is. That's what it will be. Okay. Let's get into the origins of Egyptian civilization. See you in a second. Cue that music I like.
Sewing my sheets, one stitching my sneaks. As long as I can buy them both cheap, yeah. American privilege keeps blurring my vision. Inherited sickness.
Kemet, or ancient Egypt, was the civilization that emerged around the Nile Valley, mainly in the area today occupied by the Arab Republic of Egypt. And what is a Mediterranean country? Mediterranean countries are those that surround the Mediterranean Sea or located within the Mediterranean Basin. An And I am pretty sure that now you are wondering, what is he talking about? Is he crazy? Because indeed Egypt qualifies as a Mediterranean country according to that definition. Egypt and even ancient Egypt belong to the countries surrounding the Mediterranean Sea. But I reiterate my claims that Kemet was not a Mediterranean civilization, and let me explain you why. Was Kemet truly a Mediterranean civilization? A few weeks ago, while making my video about soft power in Africa, I noticed something about one of the footage clips I used. It was a video listing the cities of Kemet one after the other. It started in the north with Memphis to the south. It made me realize why many people struggle to comprehend the African identity of Kemet. It's due to their perception of it, starting from Lower Egypt. I remember talking to a prominent TikToker a few months ago. Our conversation was about ancient Egypt being a black civilization. He told me that it wasn't the case, that there were a black ethnic group called Nubians in Egypt, but they were a minor group among a majority of Mediterranean Egyptian people. And that's how people perceive Kemet. A Mediterranean Eurasian civilization with a black minority in the south. But that's completely false. What we call ancient Egypt didn't originate in the north or around the delta, which is the part of the country bordering the Mediterranean Sea and the Levant. What qualifies as Kemet should be the area where the culture, the art, the spirituality, the kingship, and the government emerged, right? And that heartland lies between Nubia and Upper Egypt. Areas known to this day, despite the invasions, to be the headquarters of black people in Egypt. And they are nowhere near the Mediterranean Sea. So, those who were considered indigenous Kemites back in the day were these black African people. Every element constituting what became Kemet already existed prior to the integration of the Delta to that country. In fact, the Delta was not Kemet. It has been Egyptianized by the true Egyptians who came from inner Africa. As attested by all classical Kemetic literature like the Edfu texts, for example. They conquered the area, then brought all their customs. The peoples of the Delta adopted it and joined their southern civilization. There are other elements confirming this. For example, in terms of trade. During the earliest periods, Kemites traded a lot with Central Africa. It was closely linked to inner Africa with the kingdoms of Yam, Punt, and more. They knew the Central African foragers that they called the dancers of the gods. Meaning that to them, God lived where these dancers lived, in Central Africa. There was trade with the Levant too, since early periods, but the most important connections were with inner Africa. Kemet mutated into a Mediterranean civilization during the late period, when it became Egypt, due to the origins of its latest invaders, the Greeks and Romans, who were true Mediterranean civilizations. But maybe you disagree with me, and I can understand that. So, let's go deeper. Diodorus Siculus says in Book 3, the Ethiopians say that the Egyptians are a colony drawn out of them by Osiris, and that Egypt was formerly no part of the continent, but a sea at the beginning of the world, and that it was afterwards made land by the River Nile. And this testimony is corroborated by official Kemetic texts like the Edfu texts, and by geology. After scientific investigation, Reynolds states, the configuration and composition of the lowlands of Egypt leave no room to doubt that the sea once washed the base of the rocks on which the pyramids of Memphis stand, the present base of which is reached by the inundations of the Nile at an elevation of 70 or 80 feet above the Mediterranean. How remote must be the period when Egypt was not the gift of the Nile? And around 50 BCE, Diodorus expressed his respect by referring to Nubia as the home of Egyptians and of civilization itself. So, everything confirms it. However, why does it matter? By saying that Kemet was a Mediterranean civilization, we would be falsifying its history. We make it look like it started in the north and expanded south. It creates a confusion that leads many people to claim that it was created by some mysterious Mediterranean race identical to modern Mediterranean and Levantine populations. And that's a theft of history for the indigenous African-descended populations who actually created it. Kemet was a Nilo-Saharan civilization, meaning of or relating to the Nile River or the inhabitants of the Nile region and the Sahara. And it just makes sense. Its emergence and existence depended on the Nile River, not the Mediterranean. So, this is why Kemet wasn't a Mediterranean civilization.